any list of the best destinations in the Philippines isn't complete without Siargao. This island in Surigao del Norte, off the northeastern coast of Mindanao, was sort of a best-kept secret, guarded by locals and not too many adventurous travelers, until around the early 2010s, when word of the island's majestic waves exploded in the surfing world. Today, it is a tourism powerhouse, a rockstar among Philippine destinations that has been attracting groupie after groupie of tourists, wave riders, and non-surfers alike. Hey there, poor traveler! We are Vince and Josh, and in this video, we'll share with you how to plan a trip to stunning Siargao. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new travel videos. How to get there? Siargao has a small yet serviceable airport named Sayak Airport. Traveling by air is the most efficient way to get to the island. In the past, the usual route from Manila is to first take a flight to Cebu or Surigao City and then take another flight to Siargao. But this has changed when local airlines started offering direct flights to and from Manila. From Manila, it usually takes 2 hours to get to Siargao, or 1 hour if you fly from Cebu. Note that this video guide is for those who plan to travel when there are no pandemic threats. If you're planning to visit soon in the time of COVID, make sure you follow all the travel and health policies. You can find a link to the list of travel requirements in the description below. Where to stay? You'll never run out of options when it comes to accommodations in Siargao. The island attracts tourists within the full spectrum of budget preferences. So whatever your budget is, there is a hotel, hostel, or resort to fit your needs. If you're looking for a place that's close to surfing spots and other major attractions, we highly suggest that you stay within General Luna. Cloud9, Quicksilver, and other surfing camps are located here and are just a short habble-habble ride away. Many hotels, resorts, and restaurants are also found here. It's easy to find a great place in General Luna. We always stay at La Luna Island Resort, which is owned by a friend who is also a travel blogger. Its rooms are spacious, beds huge, and location excellent, close to a wide selection of dining spots.
Hi guys! So, nandito namin sa Siargao and it's our day 1 here. Ang luwag ng room. Kasya kaming tatlo dito sa kama. Ayun. Laki, di ba? Yun, we'll be staying here for 5 nights. So, if planning to go to Siargao, tapos may sa General, along General Luna yung pinagstayan nyo, yung mga van transfers naman doon, ng mga shuttle rides.
How to transfer from the airport. Now that you know where to stay, it's time to figure out how to get there from the airport. While most of the hustle and bustle occur in General Luna, the airport is located in Del Carmen, which is a separate municipality. To get to General Luna, you may travel by van, by motorcycle, or by multi-cab. Traveling by van is your cheapest option, but you may have to share the vehicle with other passengers. Head outside the airport where vans for rent are parked. If you're feeling adventurous or you'd like to travel privately, you can also get to General Luna on a motorcycle, either via habal-habal or for rent motorbikes that you operate yourself. These are also available outside the airport. Another popular form of transport is the multicab, which are small multi-seater vehicles that look like bonsai trucks. Multicabs have enough space for luggage and the ride is relatively more comfortable than the two-wheeled options. How to get around? The habal-habal motorcycle, a common sight in rural Philippines, takes center stage in Siargao as the primary mode of transportation. These motorcycles bear quirky designs. Getting around on these icons of rural ingenuity is cheap and fast. If you only want to get around General Luna proper, it only costs 20 pesos per ride. You can also explore the island by tricycle or by renting a motorcycle, a bike, or a car. When to visit? Siargao is a year-round destination, but the best time to visit depends on why you're visiting in the first place. Like the rest of the Philippines, Siargao Island has dry and wet seasons. It's relatively dry between March and November, while the rest of the months are frequented by monsoon rains. If you're going to Siargao solely for surfing, then these seasons don't really matter. The waves are strong year-round. However, September to November is particularly enticing since various activities take place at these times, most prominent being the Siargao Cloud9 Surfing Cup. If you're going to Siargao for other leisurely activities aside from surfing, then the dry season between March and November is your best bet. Take into consideration that most travelers have the same mindset too, and Siargao might get more crowded than usual during these months. Where to eat? The town of General Luna has the most commercial establishments on the island: resorts, restaurants, cafes, and bars. Because the island is a famous tourist destination and some ingredients have to be sourced from other provinces, food prices are on the expensive side. Some of the most favored restaurants are the following. If you're on a budget, choose to eat at simple eateries or carinderias instead of the more upscale restaurants. It's easy to find one within the island. When the sun goes down, the nightlife starts to kick in, and it's very much alive on the island. If you still have the energy for dancing and socializing with other travelers, parties usually happen at the following. Things to do. Here are some of the best activities in Siargao. We'll not go into detail because we'll be making a part 2 of this video with more information about each of these stops. So make sure to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell so you won't miss our next videos.
Cottage namin sa before kami pumunta dito, namalengke na kami ng aming kakainin and ayun, nagpaluto tapos after nito, 3 PM diretso kami ng Naked Island. Ang Naked Island mga, nakikita namin dito, hindi ko alam kung nakukuha ng video so nandun siya sa side.
Other tips to remember. Bring enough cash. There are ATMs in Siargao, but signal losses make them unreliable at times. It's best to bring enough cash with you or use credit cards for major transactions. Leave no trace. Don't leave trash on the beach. Whatever you bring to the place, take them with you when you leave. Practice sustainability. Let's do our small part and ensure the island remains pristine by bringing our own water bottles, using coral-friendly sunscreen, and not littering. Don't sweat safety. Wear life vests when on the boat and wear aqua shoes on beaches and rocky shores. If you need more information about traveling around Siargao, you'll find a comprehensive travel guide with a sample itinerary on our blog www.thepoortraveler.net or check out the link in the description. If you have questions, sound off in the comment section below. You can also find us on Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook. Just look for @thepoortraveler, single L. You may also follow and tune in to The Poor Traveler Podcast on Spotify. That's all for now, and remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.